Hello and welcome to Tenable, the show where naming a top 10 can win you a top cash prize. For example, if I asked for the top 10 things women look for in a partner, and you said sense of humour, you'd be laughing all the way to the bank. But if you said dandruff, that would be a flaky answer. The more top 10s our team can beat, the greater their jackpot will be. So let's meet today's team. It's Knots on Your Nelly. Hello, Knots on Your Nelly. So tell me about your team.
So we are a group of friends that met at the University of Nottingham 13 years ago.
OK, you lot from Knots, let's go win you lots and lots and lots. OK, Knots on Your Nelly, it's time to release the first question. The 10 currencies of European countries. OK, Dave, as captain, you need to decide who's the best teammate for this one.
OK, I am thinking, Magnus, this has got your name on it.
Oh, OK.
All right then, Magnus, please join me to play Tenable. Hey, Magnus, welcome to the game.
Hello, Warwick.
You look delighted to have been chosen.
I think it will be a challenging one, but I'll give it a go.
So what do you do for a living, Magnus?
I work in marketing for an insurance company.
I see. I'm told you love going to Norway.
Yeah, I've got family over there, so hoping to go soon in a few weeks and do some skiing.
Lovely. You know, I went to Norway and hired an amphibious car. It was a Fjord Mondeo. OK, Magnus, here's how the game works. 5 correct answers will earn you a place in the final and add £1,000 to the prize fund. You've got a life, so you can make one mistake, but any more than that and you're out of the game. The team has 3 nominates to use across the show. If you can't think of an answer, you can nominate a teammate to provide one for you. Also, your team captain, Dave, can overrule one of your answers. So, are you ready to play Tenable?
Yes.
Good. Here's your question again. The 10 currencies of European countries. Now, I will just clarify this for you. The Tenable Tower will show a list of 10 countries in Europe. We're looking for the 10 names of the official main units of currency for each of those countries. Is that clear?
Yes.
Good. Here are your 10 clues. Serbia, Germany, Hungary, Switzerland, Sweden, Albania, Bulgaria, Turkey, Russia, and Poland. There are the 10 countries. Let's get your first currency on the board.
OK, so I'll go for Sweden. I'll pick the krona.
Let's have a look. Is krona our first tenable answer? Yes, well played. That's tenable. Let's get another answer on the board.
We will go for franc.
Let's have a look. Is franc tenable? Yes, there it is.
OK, my next one will be... I'll go for the euro.
Is euro tenable? Yep, there it is. Well done, Magnus. This is going well. Feeling good?
I'm now kind of humming and ahhing a little bit on the next.
Don't forget, you've got the nominates if you need them.
I'm going to have to use a nominate, I think.
Who would you like to nominate?
I'd probably go with Dave to help me out on this one.
Thank you, Magnus.
So, Dave, you've been nominated. Can you help Magnus with an answer?
Not really. I don't think I can.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe it might be one of them. I'm going to say the dollar.
You don't have to take that answer. He doesn't seem very sure.
I'll take Dave's just because I haven't got an alternative.
Is dollar tenable? Now, that was untenable, I'm afraid. Oh, Dave, look what you've done.
Sorry.
Sir Magnus has lost a life. Ah. So be careful. Another incorrect answer means what?
Unfortunately, I'll go into the vortex.
You will indeed, yes, absolutely.
Yeah. Not sure I want to burn any more kind of our nominations. So I think I'm just going to have to take a gamble. Let's just say Deutschmark.
To keep you in the game, is Deutschmark tenable? Untenable, Magnus. Well, sadly, you haven't added any money to the prize fund or secured a place in the final. Bad luck, sir. All right, let's look at these missing answers, shall we? So Poland has the zloty, and Russia has the ruble.
Oh, yeah.
Turkey's currency is lira. Bulgaria has lev. Albania's currency is lek. Hungary, their currency is the forint, and Serbia's currency is a dinar. So there you go. You'll never forget those, will you?
Never, no.
Well, Magnus, it saddens me to say you are terrible at tenable. See ya. Off he goes into the vortex, the most amazing quiz show holding area ever conceived. Team, you've got nothing in your prize fund, but can you change that? It's time to look at your next list. The 10 judges and presenters on The Great British Bake Off and Extra Slice. So, Dave, who's the best teammate for this one?
I am going to go for Tully.
Natalie, please join me to play Tenable.
Come on, Tully.
Natalie, you gave Dave a filthy look then.
Didn't mean to.
So you're not happy with this question?
I can give it a go. I'm not getting to 10.
You've got
no
choice,
already.
I'm sorry to say.
Good point.
So, Natalie, what do you do?
So, I'm a product manager for a company that manufactures and sells equipment used to diagnose cancer and other diseases.
I see. So, you get to work with doctors. Once they'll say, what do you need? What kind of equipment would you like?
Pretty much, yeah.
So, are you ready to play Tenable?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Good. Let's look at your list again. The 10 judges and presenters on The Great British Bake Off and Extra Slice. We're looking for the names of the 10 people who've been either a judge or presenter on the main series of The Great British Bake Off or the companion show The Great British Bake Off Extra Slice. This includes the main presenter and regular co-host on Extra Slice. This is up to and including the main and companion series broadcast in 2021. Is that clear?
Yep.
Good. Well, best of luck.
Thank you.
Let's get your first answer on that board.
So, I am going to start with Mary Berry.
Is Mary Berry tenable? Yes, there she is, Mary Berry.
Okay, next up, I'm going to try her companion judge, Paul Hollywood.
Is Paul Hollywood tenable? Good.
So I'm going to go for some hosts now, and I'm going to try Noel Fielding.
Is Noel Fielding tenable? Yeah, there he is. Good work. This is going well.
So far.
So, Natalie, do you bake?
A little bit, yeah. Not on the level of Great British Bake Off.
Have you ever had a soggy bottom?
Yes, on occasion.
You have 3 correct answers on the board, 2 away from £1,000 and a place in the final. Still got 2 nominates and your life. Yep. And Dave can still overrule.
So I'm going to stick with the host and go for Matt Lucas.
Is Matt Lucas tenable? Yes, well played.
I hope I'm pronouncing this right. Sandy Toksvig.
For £1,000 and a place in the final, is Sandy Toksvig tenable? Yes, that satisfying sound means you've got 5 tenable answers and you've won a place in the final. We'll also add £1,000 to your prize fund. Well done, Natalie.
Thank you very much.
Now, you can stop there if you wish. but there are still 5 answers left to reveal. If you think you know more, you can play on. Your next correct answer is worth £2,500. But be warned, if you play on, you'll be on your own.
OK. So I believe that the most recent judge is Pruleith.
Mm-hmm. So, for £2,500, is Pruleith tenable? There she is. Well played. That's £2,500 into your prize fund.
So, I believe the presenter of Extra Slice, although I've not watched it, is Joe Brand.
So, for £5,000, is Joe Brand tenable? Yeah, there she is. Well played, Natalie.
Thank you.
You're doing really well here, considering you didn't want to do this, Liz. You're in perfect 10 territory now.
Oh, no, I wouldn't go that far. I'm going to try Mel Gedroych.
So, for £10,000, is Mel Gedroych tenable? Wow, this is amazing, Natalie. Look at this, you're 2 away from a perfect 10 here on Tenable and £25,000.
I believe Mel's partner was also a presenter at one point, and that is Sue Perkins.
For £15,000, is Sue Perkins tenable? Yeah, there she is. Brilliant. Well, Dave, it seemed like you chose well here.
Good choice, yeah, good choice.
Maybe you know what you're doing after all. OK, Natalie, you're very close to a perfect 10.
I don't think I'm going to get there. I'm really struggling with who was. I'm just going to guess someone who I know won, who may potentially have been on it, and go with Nadia. But I think her last name's Sawala.
For a perfect 10 and £25,000. Is Nadia Sawala tenable? Oh no, she was untenable. Oh, Natalie, you've lost your life now.
Yeah, and I think I've just thought of who it was.
Well, be careful. Another incorrect answer means you'll lose the £15,000 you've banked.
Yeah.
And you'll be heading out through the vortex.
I'm only like 90% confident I know who it is, so I'm gonna walk away now.
Okay, Natalie, you've decided to take the money. We'll add that £15,000 to your team's prize fund, and you're guaranteed a place in the final with your captain, Dave. Yeah. Okay, Natalie, what was the answer you were 90% sure about?
Tom Allen.
Okay, let's see. Mm. This could have been worth £25,000. Who's behind number 10?
Yep.
It is Tom Allen.
Sorry, guys.
Well, Natalie, you've added a stonking £15,000 to your prize fund, and you'll return later on to play for it in the final. Well played, Natalie. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Well done, Natalie. Air 5.
Up next, another member of Knots on Your Nelly steps up to their game board. Grab something edible, then come back to Tenable. Welcome back to Tenable, where Knots on Your Nelly have been lighting up some lovely lists. Natalie has made it through to the final and they've banked a gobsmacking £15,000, but they've lost teammate Magnus. Let's get straight on with our next Tower of 10. The 10 washing machine brands sold by Argos. So, Dave, who's the right person for this one?
Elliot's into his gadgets.
Is
so,
it?
Elliot, I think this is for you.
Okay. Elliot, it's time to play Tenable. Elliot, welcome to the game. So what's your job?
So I am a program manager for Jaguar Land Rover, working on the next generation of future cars.
Well, that's exciting. So is any of your work out on the road already?
Yeah, yeah. Most recently, the Jaguar I-Pace, which is the first electric vehicle that the brand has made. So.
Any chance of a discount? I'll tweet about it. OK, Elliot, time to beef up that bank. You know the rules. Five tenable answers will earn you a place in the final and add £1,000 to the prize fund. You've got a life and two nominates, and your captain, Dave, can overrule one of your answers. So, are you ready to play Tenable?
I think so.
Good. Here's your question again. The 10 washing machine brands sold by Argos. I'll clarify this for you. We're looking for the 10 brands of washing machine listed on the Argos website. These are the brands that appeared on the washing machine page of the Argos website on the 8th of December 2021. So, Natalie, does he know how to use a washing machine?
He can just about manage it, yeah. Doesn't know how to get his clothes into the wash bin, but that's a different story.
OK, well, good luck with this, Elliot.
Thank you.
Let's get your first answer on the board.
I think first up, I'm going to go Samsung.
Is Samsung our first tenable answer? Yes, it is. Well done. Good start, Elliot.
Yes. OK, next up, I'm going to go with Bosch.
Is Bosch tenable? Yep, there it is. Well done.
OK. I'm not sure about this one, but I'm going to go with Hotpoint.
Is Hotpoint tenable? So that sound means your captain has hit the overall button, or as we're calling it today, the that's not correct button. Dave, you don't like the sound of his answer.
I don't know if that's more ovens and microwaves and things.
OK, Dave. You now have to give an answer to replace Elliot's.
I am thinking Zanussi.
So you're saying Zanussi. Well, Elliot, before we see if your captain was right to overrule, we have to see whether your answer is up there. You said...
Hotpoint.
OK, let's have a look. Is Hotpoint tenable? We're hoping it's not. No, that was tenable. Dave.
Sorry, Elliot.
You just cost Elliot an answer.
Sorry, Elliot.
Dear. But now we have to see whether your answer is up there. Remind me of what you said.
Zanussi.
Let's have a look. I'm hoping it's up there for your sake, Dave. Is Zanussi tenable? That's untenable. Oh, Dave, yes, hold your head in shame. You've now cost Elliot an answer and his life. All right then, Elliot, so get yourself back together here.
Yeah.
This has sent you all in a spin cycle. Still got the nominates, but maybe don't nominate Dave.
No, I think I'll avoid Dave for the next few weeks.
Let's get another answer on the board.
I'm going to go Siemens.
So Siemens. To keep you in the game, is Siemens tenable? Untenable.
Oh, dear.
Oh, Elliot. Sadly, you haven't added any money to your prize fund and you haven't secured your place in the final. Bad luck. Before we say goodbye, though, let's reveal these missing washing machine brands. Behind number 9 is... It's a New World. Number 8, LG. Number 7, Indesit. Number 5, Hoover.
Oh.
Number 4, it's Candy. Number 3, Bush.
Yeah.
And number 1 is Beko. Well, Elliot, it saddens me to say you and Dave are terrible at Tenable. Goodbye. We have one last list before Captain Dave faces his tower and attempts to win back Magnus and Elliot ahead of the final. Their prize fund currently stands at £15,000, but can they add to that pot? Now, Louise, you're the only teammate left to play, so let's hope you're the right person for this one. Come and play Tenable. So, Louise, welcome to the game.
Thank you.
I hear you've been reading Harry Potter in French.
Mm.
How come?
Well, I bought the books a long time ago. I lived in France for a year after university. Mm. Thought I'd give it a go. So, yeah, it was an interesting experience.
You know, I can read Harry Potter in French. Easy. Look. Harry Potter. So, do you have a favourite character in Harry Potter?
Racking my brains, really.
Keep racking.
Probably Luna Lovegood.
Any more come to mind?
Someone who worked in the bank, maybe?
Maybe.
No. The school teacher.
Any particular teachers?
Professor Flitwick.
Good, we got there in the end. So, are you ready to play Tenable?
I am ready.
Good. Here's your question. 10 animal title characters. OK, I shall clarify this for you. This is about the names of animals that are the title characters of books. The Tenable Tower will show 10 types of animal with the name of an author and the year each book was first published. We're looking for the 10 corresponding given names of the animals as they appear in each title. So, is that clear, Louise?
Yes.
Good. Here are your 10 clues. Deer, Felix Salten. Horse, Anna Sewell. Spider, E.B. White. Dog, Stephen King. Monkey, Margaret and Hans Ray. Duck, Beatrix Potter. Whale, Herman Melville. Cat, Judith Kerr. Bear, Michael Bond. And otter, Henry Williamson. So there are the 10 animals.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get your first character name on the board.
Okay. I'm going to go for Black Beauty.
Is Black Beauty tenable? Yeah, then Black Beauty, well done.
I'm going to go for Charlotte.
Is Charlotte tenable? Yeah, that's tenable. Charlotte was the spider in Charlotte's Web.
OK. I will go next for Moby Dick.
Is Moby Dick tenable? Well played, Louise.
I think I know the duck is Jemima Puddle Duck.
Let's have a look. Is Jemima tenable? Jemima Puddle Duck. That's a quacking answer. So look at this, you've got 4 correct answers on the board, 1 away from £1,000 and that place in the final.
Mm-hmm.
You've got 2 nominates.
Mm-hmm.
This is your last chance to use those.
Okay.
And you've still got your life. And this is Dave's last chance overall. Slightly worrying.
I think Paddington Bear.
So for £1,000 and that place in the final, is Paddington Bear our 5th tenable answer? Yes, that cheerful tune means you've got 5 tenable answers and you've won a place in the final.
Great.
We'll also add £1,000 to your prize fund. Well done.
Good.
Now,
good.
Louise, you can stop here if you wish, but there are still 5 answers left to reveal. If you think you know more, you can play on.
Yeah.
Your next correct answer is worth £2,500. You've still got a life, so you can make 1 mistake.
Yeah. I'm going to go for Mog.
For £2,500, is Mog tenable? There's Mog. Well done, that's £2,500 into your prize fund.
Yep.
Your next correct answer is worth £5,000.
This is probably just the film, but I'm thinking of the deer maybe being Bambi.
For £5,000, is Bambi tenable? Yes, there is. Okay. Well done. So, Louise, okay. That's £5,000 in job
prize. I wasn't expecting that to be right.
Your next correct answer is worth £10,000.
Right. It's very tempting.
Looking at this, it's a good job you and Natalie are in this team.
Yeah. Oh, the otter. I really don't know, actually. So I'm just going to have a guess at the monkey. King Kong?
For £10,000, is King Kong tenable? Untenable, I'm afraid.
Mm, okay.
Oh, Louise, you've lost your life now. Be careful here.
Yeah. I think I'm going to have to sit down.
So you've decided to take the money. Yeah. We'll add that £5,000 to your prize fund, and you're guaranteed a place in the final with Captain Dave. Before you sit down, now, let's reveal these missing answers. The otter was... Tarka. No. What about this monkey? Curious George. And the dog... That's Cujo.
Not heard of that.
Well, Louise, you've added £5,000 to your prize fund, giving your team a tenable-tastic total of £20,000. And you return later on to play for it in the final. Congratulations, Louise. Well played.
Thank you. Thank you.
Join us after this quick break when Captain Dave takes on his tenable tower. Brew, Lou, back in a few. Welcome back to Tenable, where these guys want to take plenty of notes back home to Nottingham. There's just one more chance for the team to add to their jaw-dropping £20,000 jackpot. And this time it's down to their skipper Dave to take on the tower. Now, Dave, as you're the captain, you'll definitely be taking part in the final. But this is your chance to get your team in the best possible shape before you play for that jackpot. Please come and play Tenable. Hello, Dave.
No worries.
So, are you happy with your team?
I think the girls have done fantastic. Mm. Boys, I think they had some tricky categories. I would have struggled with them as well.
Now, I'm told you often get mistaken for other people.
I mean, this happened a couple of times. I was in the middle of Madrid in one of the main squares and had some tourists come up to me and say, am I Rowan Atkinson, Mr. Bean? Which I don't think I look like him at all, but I was told that.
Fabulous. OK, Dave, let's light up your board. Just like the previous rounds, there's another potential £25,000 up for grabs. As always, you need 5 correct answers to get onto the money ladder. But this time, on your 5th correct answer, you'll have to decide to take the £1,000 for your prize fund or forego the cash to win back either Magnus or Elliot. Now, they're waiting in the wings, desperate to help you win that jackpot. But first, you've got to win them back. You've got a life, and your team have left you with 2 nominates. And, of course, you can't overrule yourself. Thank
really
goodness.
Good job, yeah.
So, are you ready to play Tenable?
I am ready to play, yes.
All right, then, Dave. Here's your question. The last 10 British men to win an Olympic gold athletics medal as an individual. We are looking for the last 10 male athletes to win at least 1 gold athletics medal at a Summer Olympic Games as an individual competitor. So is that clear?
Yes, that's clear.
Good. Let's get your first answer on the board.
OK, so I'm going to go with Mo Farah.
Is Mo Farah tenable? Good start, Dave. Let's continue in that vein.
Slightly further back, Jonathan Edwards.
Is Jonathan Edwards tenable? Yep, that's tenable. Well done.
OK, I think between the two of them, I'm going to go for Greg Rutherford, long jumper.
Is Greg Rutherford tenable? Yeah, there he is. He won gold in the 2012 long jump.
Well, seeing as I've got a nominate, I'd like to nominate Tally.
So, Natalie, you've been nominated. Can you help Dave with an answer?
obviously I know he's affiliated with the Olympics, so I'd potentially go for Sebco.
Yep, so I'm going to go for Sebco.
Is Sebco tenable? Great. He won gold in the 1500 metres in 1980 and 1984. Well played, Natalie. Good work.
Thank you.
So you've got four correct answers on the board. You're one away from £1,000 or the chance to win back a teammate. This is your last chance to nominate in your game.
So, simply again, because I've got to nominate, Louise, I'll just nominate you.
So, ooh. Louise, what do you got? Anything?
I'm going to go for Linford Christie.
Yeah, Linford Christie. Good answer.
So, for £1,000 or the chance to win back a teammate, is Linford Christie tenable? Yeah, there's Linford Christie. Well done. Good work, Dave. That terrific tone means you've got five tenable answers. Well done. But now you need to decide, do you want to take the £1,000 for your prize fund? Or would you like to win back Magnus or Elliot?
I'm going to bring back Magnus.
You're going to bring back Magnus. That's four of your team in the final. Now, as always, you can play on. Another correct answer will put £1,000 into your prize fund or win back Elliot. So what do you want to do? Still got your life?
I'm going to go for Daley Thompson.
So for £1,000 or the chance to win back Elliot, is Daley Thompson tenable? Yes, he is. Well done, Dave. So, you can either add £1,000 to your prize fund or win back Elliot. What would you like to do?
I'm going to win back Elliot.
Great. So that's all of your team joining you in the final. Your next correct answer is worth £1,000.
I'm going to try Steve Ovett.
So, for £1,000, is Steve Ovett tenable? Yeah, there he is. Well played. He won the 800 metres in 1980. So that's £1,000 into your prize fund for that.
Okay.
Your next correct answer is worth £2,500. And you've still got your life.
Yeah. Again, I'm not sure whether it was either gold or silver, but I'm going to go for Alan Wells.
For £2,500, is Alan Wells tenable? There he is. Won the 100 metres gold in 1980. It's going very well, Dave. You're just two away from a perfect 10 now. Your next correct answer is worth £5,000.
This is definitely much earlier, but I can just think of Roger Bannister.
You're saying Roger Bannister?
Yep.
For £5,000, is Roger Bannister tenable? Didn't think it was tenable, and it wasn't.
No.
Roger Bannister took part in the 1952 Olympics, but didn't win a medal. Oh, Dave, you've lost your life now.
Yeah.
Be careful. Another incorrect answer means you'll lose the money you've banked, plus Elliot and Magnus.
OK. I'm going to call it quits. I'm going to leave it there.
OK. You've decided to take the money. We'll add the £2,500 to your team's prize fund. And you've also brought back Magnus and Elliot. Before you sit down, though, let's reveal these missing answers. Who's behind number 10? It's Lynn
David's
Davies.
Long jump.
Number 9 is David Hemery.
David Hemery.
Well, Dave, you've added £2,500 to your prize fund and brought back Magnus and Elliot to help you in the final, which means all of you are playing for the grand total of £22,500. Congratulations, Dave. Let's hear it for you. Well done. After the break, Not Sonia or Nelly face their final board. Back in a flash when they play for the cash. Welcome back to Tenable, where Not Sonia or Nelly have all their players in the final and are playing for the bank-busting sum of £22,500. Well, knots on your Nelly. To take home that prize, this time you're going to have to give me every answer up there and achieve a perfect 10. Get 10 out of 10 and you'll be walking away with that gigantic £22,500. Well, knots on your Nelly. It's time to face your final Tower of 10. For your final list, you have two categories to choose between. Let's take a look. UK cities, Amy Winehouse. So, team, what do you like the look of?
I'm thinking UK cities.
Yeah.
UK cities, I think.
So you're going for UK cities. From this point on, there is no conferring. On your turn, you must say one answer and nothing else. You've chosen UK cities. Let's reveal your final list of 10 worth £22,500. The 10 one-word UK cities that contain the letter G. This is about cities with official city status in the UK. We are looking for the 10 cities that have a one-word name that contains the letter G. This is as of December 2021. Brighton is not a tenable answer, as the full name of the city is Brighton and Hove. Is that clear?
Yep.
Yeah.
Good. Dave, please take your position.
So I'm going to start with Nottingham.
Is Nottingham tenable? Yes, it is. OK. Magnus, please step forward. Welcome back, Magnus.
Thank you. I'm going to go with Edinburgh.
Is Edinburgh tenable? Yes, it is. Good work. Well done, Magnus. It was worth bringing him back. Natalie, please step forward. So, Natalie, you put £15,000 into this prize fund. Can you help win it?
I'm going to go for probably the most obvious one, Glasgow.
Is Glasgow tenable? Yep, there it is. Well done. Elliot, please step forward. So, UK cities, is that better than washing machines for you?
Just a bit. I've got an answer, so I'm going to say Birmingham.
Is Birmingham tenable? Yep, that's tenable. Well done, Elliot. Louise, please step forward. So, Louise, you've got 4 out of 4 so far.
I'm going to gamble a little bit. I'm going to go with Armagh.
Is Armagh tenable? Yep, there it is, at the top of the list. Well done. OK, Dave, you're up next. So look at this, you're halfway there already. Halfway to that £22,500 jackpot.
Yep.
And a perfect 10. Still got all your players.
I think it's a city. I'm going to go with Gloucester.
Is Gloucester tenable? Yes, it is. Well done, Dave. Good work. Magnus, please step forward. So, Magnus, what's your next answer?
So, I'm a little bit unsure if this is a city, but I'm going to go for Peterborough.
Let's have a look. Is Peterborough tenable? Out the posh. Well done, Magnus. This is going well. OK, Natalie, please step forward. So you're just 3 away from the perfect 10 and £22,500.
Yep. So I am going to go with Cambridge.
Is Cambridge tenable? Elliot, please step forward. So, Elliot, you look very confident.
I've got every confidence that the team can get there if this is wrong, so I'm going to say Stevenage.
Saying Stevenage. Is Stevenage tenable? Untenable.
Yeah.
Stevenage is a town.
Okay.
Okay, so once again, we have to say goodbye to you.
Okay.
Thanks for playing.
Thank you.
Louise, please step forward. So, your first teammate has left. Still got two answers to find.
Yeah.
Plenty of brains to find them.
So, I'm just going to have to take a guess. I'm going to go for Sligo.
Sligo.
Which is an island.
All right, then, let's have a look. Is Sligo tenable? No, that was untenable. Sligo is a town in Ireland.
Sorry, guys.
I think you knew that. Well, Louise, I'm afraid we have to say goodbye to you.
Thanks very much.
Thanks for playing. Captain Dave, please step forward. So your team is somewhat depleted.
I'm going to go with Wigan.
OK. Is Wigan tenable? Untenable. Wigan is also a town. So, Dave, we have to say goodbye to you. Thanks for playing, Captain. Magnus, step forward. So, brought back from the vortex. Now it's just you, me and Natalie and these two missing answers. So that's one correct answer each to take home the £22,500. Have you got one of these answers?
I do not. Can't even think of one that would match on the board, so I'll just say Gillingham.
OK, let's have a look. Is Gillingham tenable? So, not surprisingly, that's untenable. So, once again, we say goodbye to you, Magnus.
Thank you.
Thank you. OK, Natalie, step forward. Now, the pressure's on.
Just a little bit.
You put £15,000 into this prize fund. Can you be the one to take it home for the team?
I'm not sure if it's definitely a city, but I'm going to go for Stirling in Scotland.
OK. So, let's have a look. Is Stirling tenable? There it is. Well played. Congratulations, Natalie. That was great. Now, look at this. One answer stands between you, a perfect 10, and £22,500.
I've been racking my brains and I can't think of what is up there. I honestly can't think of a single city that has a G in it, so I'm just going to have to throw this away, and I'm really sorry to the rest of the team and say the one city I can think of that would fit up there, and that's Belfast, which I know doesn't have a G in it.
So, for a perfect 10, is Belfast our final tenable answer? Not surprisingly, that was untenable.
Yep.
So, Natalie, unfortunately, you haven't managed to top the tower and you won't be going home with that prize money. How do you feel?
Gutted that we got this far and we did so well.
You personally did play very well, putting £15,000 into that prize fund.
And I'm going to kick myself whenever this comes up, so.
Well, let's have a look at the missing answer now. So, number two was Bangor, and that's in Wales.
Yep.
Well, you've been such a fantastic team and a pleasure to have on the show today. A lot of fun.
Thank you.
Bad luck, team, but by way of consolation, you'll each be heading home with a very special tenable tea towel. So there you have it. Did they win? Not on your Nelly. Bad luck, team. Join us next time when five more contestants play Tenable. Goodbye.